Hey everyone, and welcome back to No Code Devs. Today we will be going over everything you need to know about Wix Studio's blog feature. If you're looking to share your thoughts, ideas, or updates, Wix Studio's blog makes it super easy to connect with your audience. By adding a blog to a Wix Studio site, you not only engage your visitors, but also boost your site's SEO and strengthen your brand voice. Whether you're a pro blogger or just getting started, the Wix Studio blog is super efficient to use. So let's go ahead and dive in. First, we are going to go into our Wix Studio dashboard. So as you can see on the left-hand panel, there are multiple different pages in Wix Studio that you can add to your website. For this, we will be focusing on the blog page. When you click on the blog tab, there are multiple different subheadings that pop up. There's overview, posts, comments, categories, tags, writers, monetization, and analytics. The overview page is where you can manage your posts, track the post performance, and learn about new ways to improve your blog. So if I scroll down, there is a start a post with a template section that gives you multiple different options for when you are writing your blog post. This makes it super efficient to stay consistent across all your articles. So if I click one here, you just click edit and it takes you to a whole template. Now we're gonna go back. Below that is a section titled All Blogging Tools, such as blog reports, to get insight on the traffic you are receiving on your blog, outgoing notifications that can automate to your audience, different pricing plans for your customers, and much more, such as site members, SEO settings, import posts. On the post page, this is where you will find all your published drafts, pending review, scheduled, and trash posts. So you can edit them anytime you need to. This is also where you will be creating your new articles. The comments page is where you will find every comment on every article you have published, which you can view and answer directly in this page. And you can write whatever you want in there. The categories page helps your audience and search engines find your content. If you go to create category, you can add a category name, description, category image, and edit the SEO settings, and then add all your content that fits into that category. And then you'll just save it. In the tags page, you create tags for your audience to be able to discover related content in your blog so that they can find what they are looking for. Every time you write an article, you can add a tag to it, which I will show you how to do in a few minutes directly through your blog editor. The writers page is where you can manage the writers for your blog, create, and customize their public profiles, which you can edit all in here. And it gives you multiple different options for what you can add to their profile. The monetization page shows how you can make money on your blog by creating exclusive content, ad campaigns, and much more. Then last but not least is the analytics page. This shows a detailed view of how your blog is performing. It tracks and analyzes the views, visitors, average time on page, engagement, and much more. Now that we have went through the blog page and features, let's go in and create a new blog post. So back at the blog page, we have two options. You can create a new post, or there's a more actions option. You can create a post from template, you can create category, add a writer, import posts, and then it also gives you the blog reports and blog settings. Today, we are just going to create a new post. You are going to click the Create a New Blog Post button, and it takes you to a blank canvas. For the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to copy and paste an article I wrote in the past so you can see what it looks like. So after I copy and pasted this article, this is what it looks like. As you can see on the top bar is all your formatting options. You can change the text to different sizes for heading or body text. You can bold, italicize, underline, change the color, highlight the color. You can also put something to make a sentence stand out more if you really want to emphasize it. So you would just do that here. You can also code snippet as well, which also helps emphasize. You can bullet or number your lists. You also have access to alignment and line spacing. And you can also paste the link as a word or a phrase. So I'll show you how to do this. I'll use this link right here. And I'll highlight this phrase and go up to the link button, paste the link, save, and then whenever you click this, it'll take you to the link you're directing them to. On the left-hand side of the canvas, there are also a bunch of features. In the Add tab, you can add images, AI images, gallery, a video, a GIF, or a file. So say if I wanted to add an image, I would click the image button and click what image I want to be there. I want this image, add to page, and it directly adds your image in there. You can also add elements such as a divider. You can add a button and you can edit it too in the design tab of the button. You can add a table and you can edit how many columns or how many rows you want. Then click insert table and edit that as well. You can add an expandable list. This list will expand as you go. And you can also add a poll for your audience to take. And it creates this whole poll for you. You can change the image, ask a question, and add answers. You also have options to add elements from the web, and you can even link products, events, or services straight from your Wix Studio website. In the Settings tab, this is where you can add your featured image, so you can update it with something else. This is where you will also schedule your posts. You can schedule it or publish it right whenever you write it. You can change the writers. You can also add a little quick excerpt into here. And this is what will show up whenever people look for your blog post. And then this is where you can add your categories and tags that I was showing you earlier. You can also add more than one, and you can set whichever one you want as your main category for the blog post. In the SEO settings tab is where you will do all your SEO easily. You can add a focus keyword. So if I want to add mine here, and then once you add your focus keyword and save it, it will give you recommendations for the rest of your SEO. So allowing this post to get indexed, it's already checked off. A lot of these things are already checked off that I already have done, but it also recommends me to write alt text for images. So if you wanted to do that, you would just click your image, settings, and add alt text over here, and then you would save it. You can also write a meta description with a focus keyword that you use. So I would add text, make sure Wix Studio is in there, then press apply, and then it would be approved. It goes off all the SEO you need for your blog post to be successful. There's also a basics tab and advanced tab where you can edit your SEO even more and how you want your social share to look like if you're posting your blog posts on your social media platforms. The monetize tab is where you can create and manage plans for readers to access exclusive content on your blog. The translate tab is just where you would add a language menu to your site if you have an audience that reads in different languages. You can also add more apps to drive more traffic to your blog, which is the app that we use, and then you can add more on the website. The blog editor even has AI tools integrated so you can write and publish your posts faster. Your blog post also saves as you edit, and then you can preview your blog post before you publish it to make sure everything looks good, and it'll look like how it will directly on your website. And then when you're done, you click publish. And that's a wrap on our deep dive into Wix Studio's blog feature. As you can see, it's packed with everything you need to create, manage, and grow a successful blog, all while keeping things streamlined and user-friendly. If you found this tutorial helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to No Code Devs for more no code tips, tricks, and tutorials. If you have any questions, drop a comment below. We'd love to answer them for you. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.